Hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today another new makeup releases. Will I buy it or is it going on the wish list or am I skipping or something like that? Drugstore and indie. So if you want to know what piques my interest, just keep on watching. So before we get into it, I have a few household messages. I did not come up with the idea of the Will I Buy It. That was created by Samantha March. She, well, got the idea to do it this way instead of an anti-haul. So I will list her playlist of these videos down below in the description box. She also created a community playlist where creators such as myself can add these types of videos to. I will leave that in my description box as well, along with my own Will I Buy It new makeup releases playlist. Shoutouts of this week are my dear ladies from the Beauty YouTubers Growth group, some ladies from the Aging Gorgeously group, and a friend of mine who unfortunately doesn't have Instagram or doesn't have YouTube, but she does have an Instagram account. So scroll down in my description box and you will see those links and names there. Go send them some love. Tell them I sent you. Yeah, if you like them, subscribe or follow or all of those things. Before I begin, I want to introduce you to a friend, and actually this is especially for Karen, and I need to check her last name, but it's Karen Kielbasa. And Karen, I hope I say your last name correctly. She commented on underneath my Halloween mini haul that she really loved all the spidery stuff, and I don't know if she saw my reaction on her comment actually before I filmed. I don't think she did, but I said that I also have a stuffed animal that I wanted to show her. So if you are afraid of spiders, look away now, but here is my stuffed spider. I call him Karel. He is we call it a cross spider because he has a white cross on his behind, and they are really common here in the Netherlands. My yard, especially my front yard, is full with them every autumn, and yeah, when they make a web they don't move, so they don't really bother me. Sometimes I need to take away their web and move it around because they tend to also do that right in front of my front door, and if you walk out in the morning and your head is in a spider web, that's not really nice. So yeah, but this is Karel. We gave spiders names. Yeah, we did. We have the they are the little, I think they're something like dust spiders or something. They just have a round body and really long legs, or maybe you call them daddy long legs, I don't know. But we call that, how do we call it again? So those kind of daddy long leg spiders, we call them yapies. Then we have the cross spiders, we call Karels. And then we have the very big, you know, those very big black hairy spiders, we call that Tinus. So that is how we name our spiders, at least in our house. But I got this from my best friend, and yeah, when I opened the package up, I was still actually quite afraid of spiders. I was getting a little bit better, but yeah, this one kind of freaked me out, but it's one of my favorite animals now. It's always downstairs in my house, and yeah, this is Karel. So Karen, this was for you, and this one is from Posh Paws. I don't know, they are from the brand is from the UK. I don't actually know if you can get these. This I got, I think 10 years ago or something like that. So I don't know if you can get them anymore, but they are from Posh Paws. So if you were afraid of spiders, you can look again now because I have placed Karel to the side. If you're getting nightmares tonight, I'm sorry, but I really wanted to show Karel. So yeah, let me go to the side a little bit. Let me open up Instagram and see what piques my interest. Oh yeah, before I begin, I have filmed this look. It is not up yet. I don't exactly know when it will be up, to be honest. But yeah, it's coming. It's my fall sunset eye. So look for that title and then you will know how I achieved this look. So let's start with... I always start with drugstore. So let's start with this from L'Oreal. I just saw this just before I went filming. But this is a fun new collaboration between L'Oreal and the new upcoming Mary Poppins movie. I love Mary Poppins. I have watched that movie so many times. I have it on DVD. It is one of my absolute favorites. I saw the trailer of the new movie along with my son and we were both like, we need to watch that movie. So when it is in movie theaters, we are going to watch it. But I thought this was really fun. It's only lippies and it has launched in Europe. Is it coming to the US? Let me see if they have... Oh, this is from Trend Mood and she will update us if it will be available in the US. She doesn't know, but it's 6 different lipstick shades and they are now available in Europe. So probably when I see them in store, if I see them in store, maybe I will pick one up because I just really like the packaging. I don't even necessarily need to know the colors, but they're probably reddish. But yeah, I like this. So that is a L'Oreal. Next we have, something a little bit weird from Revolution. I saw this and it just says your new obsession. But I always thought that, you know, when I am on the Revolution site, I know they have the brand Obsession, but I always thought it was kind of like an older line of theirs or something, but apparently it is actually a brand on its own. I did not know that, but it says underneath the pictures, meet your new obsession, the fresh faced trend led makeup brand to land at Revolution Beauty and Boots UK. It's high quality, affordable, PETA certified, cruelty free, standout vegan selection. Today this was posted, I think this was posted last Wednesday or Thursday, and they have launched 25 plus brand new products. And they include high shine lip glosses, carefully curated eyeshadow palettes complete with positive affirmations, blinding baked highlighters, and a very exciting collaboration with British beauty blogger and content creator Belle Jordan. More on that soon. I do have more on that soon, I think. Yeah, I saw this one and this is her collaboration. So you have an eyeshadow palette and you have 3 lippies. And it's nice, but the only shade, there are 2 shades that really pique my interest. And those are the orange and the purple. I have oranges, but I don't think that I have that purple. So if I were to get this palette, it would probably be for 1 shade, and I'm not going to do that. I am going to check out what Obsession has launched. I mentioned a few weeks ago Obsession and their Halloween palettes. I didn't get that one or those. And yeah, I have seen Obsession on the Revolution website. I haven't ordered anything from it. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. I actually don't know yet. But that was Obsession. And I also saw this. I already saw it on their site. Their advent calendar. And countdown to Christmas. We present our new Revolution advent calendar. Filled with makeup surprises for face, eyes and lips. So you can slay all this festive season. If you're not one for surprises, swipe to see inside. I'm swiping to see inside and it's just an assortment of goodies. You can get it now for £30 at Shop Revolution Beauty or Superdrug, and Shop Revolution Beauty is their home base site, their UK based site, and they ship internationally, and I think it will probably be £30, maybe $35 or $36, but I am not sure. So yeah, if you like advent calendars, I think they have more of these types of boxes, so go check out the Revolution site. I'm probably going to skip over this one. I saw what was inside and it didn't really pique my interest, to be honest. But yeah, just so you know. I also have Max Factor, and this was posted by Max Factor NL, and it is their new Radiant Lift Foundation. The foundation is enriched with SPF 30, which I'm not a fan of. I don't mind it, but I don't look for an SPF in my foundation because I put a separate SPF on anyway. But it's also enriched with hyaluronic acid and micro pearls for a fresh, glowy, evened out skin tone, something like that. I needed to translate it because it says it here in Dutch actually. I haven't seen this foundation. I have a foundation from Max Factor, their Healthy Skin Mix. I don't like that one. It dries out my skin and I don't know why. As far as I know, it doesn't contain any alcohol. But yeah, if I see this one in store and they are having a sale, I will probably pick it up, because the retail price on this foundation is €17.99. And that's just crazy for a drugstore foundation. But yeah, again, if I see it, I will probably get it on sale. I have to mention that. What else do I have? Was that everything from drugstore? I think it was. So let's go to Morphe, which is, yeah, kind of in between or something for me. I saw this. This is from Makeup Hunters News, and it is just a small 9-pen eyeshadow palette. It says that this is the first product of the Morphe Holiday Collection. It's called About Last Night Palette 9N, and it includes 9 shades: brown, nude, orange, gold, green. And it will retail for $12. It also says coming to Ulta Beauty. So I have no idea if it will be on their Morphe site or what, but let me see the picture. What I do like is that Morphe is bringing out a 9-pen eyeshadow palette. I really like that. I'm not going to get this because the colors that are in here I already have. But if you want to try Morphe and you are, well, put off by their big palettes, check out the small palette that they are apparently releasing around holiday time. So that was Morphe. What is this? Oh yeah, I also have something else from Oh My Glitter, Oh My God. I mentioned them last week, but she is, let me see, she has made loose neon pigments. They are only limited numbers available, and they are special edition for October. They shine under a black light too, so that is fun. I have a picture of a red one, a yellowy orangey one, green. Well, you can see because I will put them underneath each other. I think they're fun. I have never worked with loose pigments before, but I think they are fun. I actually like all the colors. So I don't know what they will retail for. I will check them out. She is UK based, so that is nice for me, and I'm kind of intrigued by those loose pigments. What I showed you last week was a picture of what I thought were the swatches of the Lexicon palette. And here we have also a picture of the inside. So here you can see it all together. You can see the swatches on the arm without just how they swatch on your arm. You can see the inside of the palette, and you can see a picture of one of the fronts of the palette. And I think it's really pretty. The only two mattes you get are a black and a white. I mentioned that last week. I think it's really pretty. I know she handcrafted the outer packaging at least. I don't exactly know if she also pressed the inside herself, but I know that she does a lot of things at home. This palette retails for £60. That is way, way too expensive for me. It is also limited edition. And unfortunately, I have to pass on this. I actually am kind of sad about it because I think it's gorgeous. But again, £60 is just too much, too high of a price for me. That will come for me around, depending on the exchange rate, maybe 62, 63 euros or something. And that's just too much for an eyeshadow palette for me now. So unfortunately, I am going to pass. But I really like it, and I just wanted to show you the picture of everything together because I think she did an amazing job on this. So well done, oh my glitter, oh my god. What else do I have? Yes, this is the collaboration between Beauty Creations and Esmeralda Bebilasio. I hope I say that right. From what I understood, she is the CEO of Beauty Creations. I'm not sure. So if I am not right about that, don't bite my head off. But they created an eyeshadow palette. And I think it's very pretty. Do I know what it will retail for? I don't think so. Let me see if I can find out. Does it say so here? Oh, there are two eyeshadow palettes. Volume 1 and Volume 2. Okay. Oh yeah, they are the same. No? Oh no, they are not the same. Oh wow, so they are coming out with two eyeshadow palettes. Maybe I need to clean my lenses. They will launch the 24th of October, 12 p.m. PST. Oh, and apparently they are a dupe for the Natasha Denona palette. At least someone says that here in the comments. I don't know. I have no idea. I really don't look at Natasha Denona because she's just so above my price range. I cannot find what it will retail for, so I'm sorry about that. But they will launch the 24th of October. They are pretty. I do have to say the one on the top with the orangey shades in it, I kind of have something like that in my Revolution Reloaded Iconic palette. And it actually looks quite a bit like that, to be honest. I have it here in front of me because I played with it today. But this is the Iconic palette. So let me do this. And let me hold it here so you can see it side by side. I will put it up a little bit here. But it really looks like the one on the top, to be honest. So yeah. It's not the same, but it really looks like it. And the other oranges I have, so I'm going to pass on the top one for sure. And I am actually going to pass on the bottom one as well. Because, to be frank, I have all those colors. Granted, they are spread out through different palettes, but I have them. So I am going to pass, but you know, maybe you will like that. If I have more information or maybe a price next week, I will let you know. Next up is Belegant Cosmetics. I have here their gorgeous Gem Obsession palette. And it has launched. The palette is so gorgeous. Will you be picking it up? Can I see a price? Available now. It is $35. And you get actually two eyeshadow palettes in one. But I think it's actually a great price. You know, you get two eyeshadow. I'm not a fan of the glitter shades in the center, but you get two eyeshadow palettes. It's $35. Are they glitters or are they shimmers? I think they are pressed glitters though. I am not sure. It could also be that they are shimmer shades, that the other shades are maybe matte and satin and these are foiled shimmers. I don't know. But I like the idea. I really like the idea. Unfortunately, she is in the US. Does she have an Etsy shop? No. You get free shipping over $50. So yeah, I like this palette. I am going to pass, however, because it is in the US. So shipping maybe is okay, but I get import tax if I am over a certain amount. So that is bad, but I do like, I really like this palette. And if it was UK based, I would probably get this. Just so you know. What else do I have? P. Louise. Last week I told you about the colored P. Louise bases. I here have a picture of their holiday collection. And it is quite a lot. You have the basic brights. Those are the colored eyeshadow bases. They come in a pack and they will retail for £48. You get Rude Boy Red, Yes Eye Yellow, Banging Blue, Popping Pink, QTT Orange. The color base has been invented to cut the crease, create fierce eyeliner and rainbow ombre lids, guaranteed to be smudge proof and crease proof. But you also have from the basic the winter edition, and those are pastel shades. So the top one of the colored tubes is 48. The one underneath that is their winter edition. It's £38. You have pastel shades. You have better black base. Oh no, wait, you have pastel shades. That's it. Yeah. I don't have any shade names. Then you get a better black base. So they also made a black base that will retail for £19. You have the base Pro, which retails from £18 up to £29. And the shade 2 Rumor is in 30 mils or 50 mils. The big better base is £100. And that is the limited edition base shade 2 in Rumor, and that is 330 mils. Then you get the Mirror Mirror Brush Collection, £24. It's a mixture of non-synthetic and synthetic hairs, and you get 3 base brushes, small, medium and large. It will be available officially in November, but you can pre-order now. And shipping will be between the 26th of November and the 7th of December. So yeah, a lot of pastel colors are really sheer on your eyes. So yeah, I think that you can, if you love pastels, maybe check this out, because now you have it in a cream formula. I don't know, I hear very mixed signals about the P. Louise base. Some love it, some hate it, some say it's not really for when you have hooded or eyes or something like that, so I don't know. I thought it retailed for £10, but apparently the price went up, or I misread that. So yeah, I haven't picked it up yet, and I don't know if I'm going to anytime soon, because I have a few eyeshadow primers here that I need to get through first. But if you like the P. Louise base, you can get a lot more now. So that is P. Louise. I also have here a Makeup Addiction Cosmetics. It's their new Sinful Eyes. I'm not sure if I have mentioned this one already, actually. So the pre-order for this palette is on now. In the pre-order, you can get it for £29.75. And after the pre-order is over, it will retail for £35. Let me check the colors. Not really a fan of some of the shade names, but then again, I don't really care as well. Yeah, I think it's pretty. I don't know if I will get this. I don't think so. I like the colors that are in there, but I don't know. Somehow the color story doesn't grab my attention all the way. I don't know. I'm going to think about it. So it is going on my wish list or on my maybe list. Okay, so let's go to Certify. Certify and Certify Men. I saw this. It's from their Halloween sale. If you use code TRICKORTREAT, you get 25% off. No minimum spend. Excludes sale items. It's valid until October the 31st. So that is nice. If you want to try anything from Certify, now's your chance. You get 25% off until October the 31st, again excluding sale items. I have something else from Certify as well. That's this. It is the Affinity palette, and she says it is in the pipeline. This is the front of it, I think. Maybe the back, I don't know. I think it's the front. But yeah, I don't know. I am excited to see what colors she ended up picking. If I know anything more, I will let you know. And I don't know if I will pick it up. That depends on what the shades are on the inside. I found a new indie brand. It is Max Up the Makeup Cosmetics. I have a picture of an upcoming eyeshadow palette here. You see the first 3 shades, and they look really promising. You get the color raspberry, which is a matte true red. You get beauty berry, which is a matte fuchsia. Strawberry, which is a red shimmer with gold glitter specks. Ooh. The palette that you see here is a packaging sample. It's not an accurate depiction of the packaging, but instead only used to hold the colors. So the colors are final. From what I understand, the packaging isn't. Just so you know, they haven't launched yet. Let me see if I can find out more. No, it just says coming soon. I don't know, it's cruelty free. Launching soon. I don't even know if it is UK based or US based or what. But I do have to say, those first three shades look really promising. So if I know more, I will keep you updated. Was that everything? Yeah, oh, that was everything. So let me go back here. That was everything which really piqued my interest this week. I do try to curate it a little bit as not to make the video too long. Because if I make the longer I make the video, the longer I am editing also. And this actually takes quite a while to edit. So yeah. It doesn't really matter. I really like talking about makeup. I like looking at makeup. I like, well, makeup in general. So I like doing these types of videos. What do I have here? Oh, lordy lord. Never mind. We are just going to ignore that and move on. This was it for me today. This was everything that piqued my interest this week. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know down in the comment section below if you know any of these brands, if you have ordered from them, if there is maybe something that I have forgotten to mention. And again, I also said this last week, but if you see something of interest on Instagram, tag me in it. My handle is always down below in the comment section. It's also on the screen. Now it's always on my end screen, and yeah, if you see anything interesting, tag me on Instagram and I will check it out for you. Did I say it already? Yeah, but it doesn't matter. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, just click the button. You know you want to. I am so much fun. I love creepy, hairy stuff. And all that kind of thing. And while you're clicking buttons, do not forget to click the bell, because, well, if it works, then you will be notified of my new uploads, which will be tomorrow. I am signing off for now. I wish you all a great day, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye guys.